Hello there. Being the big fan I am of Manchester City, I found it rather interesting to hear so many people saying so many things about Coach Guardiola and whether he's doing a good job, whether he's not, whether he's going to set off some of the players off the books and bring some new ones in, and this and that and the other. Maybe you do remember that the team is a long way in front of everybody in the Premier League. I think you need to understand that simply because of the fact that last season there was speculation in a lot of areas for new players. And I thought that Coach Guardiola did a fantastic job of bringing together people like Cancelo, Rodrigo, Zinchenko, as a matter of fact. Mendy was in and out of the team. And there are a number of others who needed to be in that team. They were good enough players, but they were not good enough to understand the formula of Manchester City football. Now, they have learned their lessons and they've come into this league and everywhere else. They were just a marvelous team. People are talking about which one's going to leave the team and this, that, and the other. I'm a little bit concerned. Recently, I've seen something about Sterling and the coach. I don't think that's necessary, and I don't even think it happened. We need to understand that the amount of pressure that the Premier League brings on players is very difficult, and even more so, the manager of the team. Pep Guardiola is a wonderful coach. He is not only the type of coach that runs training sessions, but he improves the quality of players on the field. He helps these players to understand the formats and the formulated plays that he is using. You look at them carefully and look at the goals that have been scored and see how they bear similarity after successful attacking play. You look at the defense, you'd see quite clearly when Stones played last year, he was really vulnerable to a certain extent, and at that time Otamendi was as well. Today, Diaz came onto the scene. What a wonderful player. What a great ruler of the game. He has on one side Walker, and he has on the other side Zinchenko, or maybe Ake, or Mendy. Whatever it is, he sets it up quite well. I thought Laporte came on for Stones. It may have been a good choice, but Stones has improved. Laporte is left-footed. And he tends to drift towards the left, leaving Diaz to cover too much of a ground at the back. I've noticed that, but he doesn't do it all the time, but it happens every now and again, and it did, in truth and fact, cause Manchester City to give up a goal or two. He's a wonderful player. He might even be better certain for the midfield. He's not going to get in there. Not with the guys I know. Not with the De Bruyns, the Fernandinhos, the Bernardo Silvas, not even the Gundogans. So it is not a question of resting them or leaving. They're leaving them there for good reasons. Whenever he selects a team, he understands fully well that the team he's got on the field, regardless of where they are on the table, he's going to select the players to perform the way he wants them to play against that particular team. Isn't that so easy to understand with a man who's thinking all the time? Have you ever seen him in fright and fear at the side of the field? No, because he knows his players will change the game and get it right. And they do it most of the time. You've got to give this guy credit. He's not only a manager and a coach, he's a teacher of the game. He has the ideas. I'm sure that he sits and he thinks a lot about each and every team that he's played against and how they play and what are their areas of strength, who are their players that are key players. At the end of it, we really don't know who are the key players simply because we beat them all. Surely there were good players, but there was also good planning from Pep Guardiola. Bear it in mind and drop the quarreling about what he's going to do, if he's going to go anywhere else, if he wants to move any play here, there, and there. Don't worry about it. The team's going to play up to the balance of the season and really do it extremely well. Let's give him the support. He's just a wonderful person, unassuming. He doesn't get erratic. He doesn't show any outward anything other than pleasantries to his players, to the former, the opposing managers. He's just the same man. Let's wish him the very best of luck. I think he's probably the best manager in football today.